I'm Don Fry, the Predator, the UFC's two-time world champion. Back when men were men, not pretty boy champions who dye their hair and, for God's sake, paint their toenails. We'd fight all night long. There were no rules, no weight limits, and no time limits. Tournament fighting. Your reward for winning a fight would be to come back 20 minutes later and fight again. At the end of the night, you can go to the hospital, or you go to the after party, or, if you're tough enough, both. I'd like to welcome all the men and women, and boys and girls, and the what's and ifs. This is my show, which means I'll call it the way I see it. No sugarcoating and no butt kissing. I'm going to say some things about your favorite fighter that are quite unflattering. That's going to hurt your little feelings. Grow up. The world's a harsh place. You'll get through it, maybe, or you'll get cast aside and stepped on, like the dog shit you are. Now get some beer and get some takeout, and let's get ready for some high-quality violence.
Oh, they're gonna go here!
Let's call our bookie, place some winning bets, and start counting the money. And one more thing, Family Guy. Will you bring back Brian, please?
Go! Bomb to be expected. In Pride Fighting Championship, demolition, and there's that right hand! They're duking it out, that right hand! Wow!
I've never seen a thing like this in my life! Unbelievable!
That was outrageous! Oh my God, look at that. Heavens!
Mr. Predator, it's time to talk.
And then what?
Remember, Dustin and Diego.
Little guys, 145 pounders.
Yep.
Old Dustin's got a record of 14-3. Toughest guy in his trailer park. Diego's been doing it twice as long. Got a record, 22-8. He'd been fighting since he was 14. His daddy passed away down there in Brazil. He had to start fighting to help support the family. When you fight to make a living, fight for the rest of your family's living, you're serious. These boys only allow 30% of their fights go to the judges. Gonna be like two mosquitoes fighting on a dry spot over a sweaty fat woman. It's gonna be a lot to go. Breaks my heart to bet against an American. But I'm gonna have to go with Diego on this one. Boys, be safe, have a good fight. But kick the crap out of each other. Next fight's a couple 155 pounders. Jim Miller from the East Coast versus Fabrico Camões Camilos from Brazil. It doesn't matter how you pronounce his name. Jimmy Boy, the American's gonna send him packing. Now, Jimmy Boy, he's been fighting for a while now. He's only allowed 7 of his fights to go to the judges. Fabrico's only allowed 4 of his fights to go to the judges. But neither one of them have great knockout power because they both only have 3 knockouts apiece. You can expect a good wrestling match out of these guys. They're going to be grappling and they're going to be looking for the submission. Save your money for the next fight. That's going to be the good one. Good luck, boys. Next fight's a heavyweight fight. Everybody's got to have a heavyweight fight on the card. Josh Barnett, ranked number 6. Bad ranking. He should be number 1. Josh is going to have that belt around his waist in a year. Travis, ranked number 5. He's got a 15-1 record. He got an 86% kill ratio. Josh's 85% kill ratio is more important because he's 33-6. He's fought the best in the world. That's why Josh is going to be wearing that belt again if he ever gets a chance to do the fight. Josh, your training says that you work out at 10:30 a.m. at Henry Tillman's Boxing Gym. You're one of my favorite people on the planet, but you look kind of like the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. You live in Southern California. Go down the beach, get a little sun on your skin. Do you wonders. Travis, ex-basketball player, 6'7", says his favorite technique is knees. Of course it's knees. All he's got to do is twitch the thing and he's right there in somebody's nose. For God's sake, he's 6'7". Travis, you're just a stepping stone for Josh on his comeback to the belt. Josh, you're a true American boy. God bless you. You're gonna get it. Our next fight. Women.
Oh, hold on a second.
Who gave you a speaking role?
Let's not pass over the next fight, shall we? Rousey and Tate. Rousey is 7-0, 100% submission.
So Tate's 13-4, got 70% submissions.
Mm-hmm. I knew you cared. My money's on Rousey.
Now that we're done with that nonsense, let's get back to business. Talking about men and fighting. The main event. Anderson Silva versus Chris Weidman, the new champion.
Keep talking about Weidman.
Why?
Because he's hot.
Hot?
Yeah. He's sexy.
We're talking about fighting here.
I don't care what we're talking about, but they're topless when they do it. Keep talking about him.
Chris Weidman is what, 10-0, 11-0 now? He got a 70% kill ratio. Anderson Silva's 35-4. He got an 80% kill ratio. He fought much better men for a longer time. Weidman's good.
He's good.
Yeah, he's good. I just said that.
He's great.
He's good.
He's good.
Is he from New York or New Jersey? It doesn't matter. He's a Yankee.
He's hot.
Anyways, this is going to be a great fight. I see these two going toe-to-toe and slugging it out and going underground like a couple of cats. I don't see any guy in it with a knockout or a submission. I see this going the distance, and I think Weidman's going to win it again, though.
I like where your head's at.
Yeah, right on my shoulders. I'm Don Fry, the Predator. Those are my predictions. Whether you like them or not, too bad. Just to piss you off, I'm gonna come back and do 169. See you sissies later.
Be sure to follow Don on Twitter during the fights. And also visit his website, www.donfry.com. See you soon.